Your learning experience will begin in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
Liftoff. We have a liftoff.
You are now ready to learn.
Hey everybody, welcome to Lights, Camera, Staging. My name is Jeff Franciotti and I am your real estate instructor for the next hour. So I want to thank you for joining me today. Happy Monday, by the way, to everybody. Thank you so much. I know we had a little bit of a dead air there and that's not what we want to have in the broadcast world, obviously. I hope you're all doing well and amazing on this Monday. Thank you for taking the time. Some of you I want to say good evening to. Some of you want to say good afternoon. Maybe some of you it's a little bit earlier. So we have people coming all over the place. And again, thank you for joining us today. Lights, camera, staging. We're going to be talking about a lot, going over a lot through the next hour. Also, too, what I want to do is make sure that this is as interactive as possible for you, right? I know we're so far apart and we got to keep ourselves away with a lot of social distancing, but I want to find a way to bring us together. So we're going to have a lot of moments to engage, to come together. We're going to have some polls. We're going to have some Q&A. We're going to have some script practice as well, too. So some script practice is going to be amazing. We're going to do some live script practicing, which should be awesome. We're going to have some opportunities for you to unmute yourself. So raise your hand, participate. More than an educator, I'm a facilitator, right? You remember Mickey with the magic hat and he was getting everything together and it was all coming together. That is you. You're the magic. I just got the magic hat from time to time. So we're all going to learn together and I'm going to learn a few things from you as well as you from this content and from me as well. First and foremost, as I said before, we're coming in from all over the place. So I would love to find out where everybody is at.
Hands.
Right? Where you at? Where you at? So I'm going to go ahead and open up a poll and let's see where you're at. And now we'll be able to test out our first poll. So I'm going to give us a little bit of time on the clock. This is a little bit of thinking music. Now we're generalized here, but I would love to see in the chat exactly where you're hailing in from. Naples, Florida. Hello, Naples. We got some Rhode Island in the house. And I'm going to be sharing exactly where. Wow, we are coming. Hawaii, Honolulu, right? Mahalo. Thank you so much for that. Oh, we are all over the place. Orlando with pride. We got New Jersey, Chicago, Orlando. Just Burlingame. Burlingame's right in my backyard, Sacramento. Tons of people coming through. We're going to put another 20 more seconds on the clock. We've got 100 of you coming in. I would love to see 100 votes rolling in as well, too. 101. We got another 15 seconds on the clock. Let's see who's going to get the biggest representation with the poll. Walnut Creek. Hello, Walnut Creek. San Francisco, Los Angeles. Yes. All right. Let's put a pin in that. Let's end that poll. Let's see who. West Coast came out in a swarm today with 42% of the votes, where Midwest came in at 19%. And the South was showing in at 11%. Northeast was coming in at 20%, and then other was 10%. So we've got people from all over the place. We're going to learn together today. So that is just one example of a poll we're going to be doing today. We're going to have a lot of opportunity, again, to engage, and this is such a great topic. Again, what we're going to be talking about is staging, how it could benefit your business, if it's something that you want to add to your business, right? And then we're going to start to look at what is the backing information behind that. We're going to start to look at analytics and numbers, and we're also going to look at how you can present that to your potential clients. So moving in, we want to jump into our first game. That's right. It's the one that everybody loves. Nobody wins. Everybody wins. It is going to be Define Your Path. That's right. Define Your Path is where you're going to let me know and us know exactly where you're at with the business, where you're at with staging, how far along lines you are with it, or have you never done it before? So let's go ahead and put a pin into that. Now, we've got several selections in here as where you're at when it comes to staging. So we've got number one, I'm a total newbie at this, right? We've got, I watch a lot of HGTV. Does that count? And it definitely, it could, right? We've got, I'm aces at decluttering and taking a good picture, absolutely. And then I have a designer eye. I give a lot of advice and feedback all over the place, from color of paint to furniture. And then it would be my job if I didn't love real estate so much. So let's get into our next poll. We're going to go ahead and we're going to share those results here, but we are going to open up our next poll for you to jump in, defining your path, and let's get some thinking music. Here we go. We saw some votes coming in through the chat, and I want to recognize and thank everybody for utilizing that, but the chat is alive. 111 of you are here today to learn together, to teach me something new, to learn something new, to learn from each other. Now, I won't tell you who is in the lead, but those votes are coming in. Love it, love it. We're going to give ourselves another 30 seconds on the clock. We've got 87 of the 111 of you participating right now in the poll. I would love to see if we get to 100, though. I've yet to get to 100%. Carol, Karen, and Annie, go ahead and make sure that you jump on the poll on that. We've got another 10 seconds left. Almost there. 86% of the voters coming in. And there we are. We're going to go ahead and put a pin into that. And let's go ahead and share those results. And here we're at. So I'm a total newbie at this. Got 23% of the votes where I watch a lot of HGTV. Does that count? I'm sure we are these days, but 14% of you voted for that. I am aces at decluttering and taking a good picture. That was 31% of you, whereas 26% of you said, I got a designer eye and I give good advice on everything from paint color to furniture. And then we had, it could be my career if I didn't love real estate so much. And that was just 6% of you. So we're running a gambit across the board. This is going to be a great place for us to pick up a new idea, a new skill set, what we have going on. So let's get into our lesson. So where do you want to be? That is a question I want to ask you. Now, most important, where do you want to be? I think I can assume that we all want at least to have a better understanding of how staging can benefit our business or how we can start to communicate. And I got a great question coming in saying, when do we start? Well, we start right now. We could start right away. We can start building those relationships. We're going to jump into that. That is a great question. Thank you for asking that. So let's start to look at some of the sources, because all this material, I didn't put this together, and the education department didn't put this together because we thought it was a good idea. We vetted veterans. We vetted successful agents across Coldwell Banker, and this is the information that they compiled into this resource, right? So a person is going to decide if they are going to consider your open house within the first 45 seconds. If their first impression doesn't excite them, you'll risk having showings where people turn around and walk out in the first 5 minutes. Let me ask you, do you feel that that is true? Do you feel like that is very true, that that first impression, right? The first that first walk-in is going to set the tone for their entire visit? As a New York for 30 years, yes, you want to start. We're going to get you started. Absolutely. Victoria says, for sure. Yes. Cheryl says, usually. Mm-hmm. 100%. I think this is absolutely spot on. What I like to do now is invite somebody to jump on board, and we can start to talk live. And I would love to get your spoken opinion on this. So go ahead and raise your hand. You have an option in to raise your hand. By the way, if you don't have the chat up, go up to more, open up chat. You can see all the chat. But go ahead and raise your hand if you'd like to come on board and let's talk about this. I'll give us a few seconds. There we go. Okay. How you doing there? Do you have me online? Michelle, do we got you? I don't know if we have Michelle. Let's see if we can get Kim. Let's see. There we go. We got Kim. Kim, how you doing today?
I'm good, but my daughter is watching drawing videos in the background.
Hey, no worries. We're all together in this. So, hey, let's talk about this just for a second, right? So within the first few seconds, this is going to be something that's going to make or break the impression or the longevity of that person viewing the house. Do you agree, disagree? What are your thoughts on that?
I actually am a licensed interior designer. So I have to say yes, 100%.
Yes, absolutely. Give us a little bit more insight on that. I mean, what's your field in being an interior designer? What are you typically experiencing?
I'm not sure what you're asking. You mean with the real estate?
In terms of setting up something for its first impression, how important is that to you to get it right off the bat?
Oh, I think it's, I can tell you just from experience, more so in the design, that the homes that turn out beautiful, people want to stay and have parties and they never leave. Mm-hmm. So the clients that I've had for that, they tell me that all the time. So I feel like it relates the same in real estate where, hey, if somebody's coming in and they think it's beautiful or nicely done, then yes, they're going to want to continue to see the house. But if not, I don't see them, you know, giving more than two steps in the door.
I absolutely agree with you. I'm going to go ahead and we're going to go ahead and drop you now, but thank you for jumping in. You're going to have an opportunity to, but thank you for that information. Thank you so much for that. And absolutely, right? I mean, we want them to right away feel at their home when they walk in, right? And so that first impression is going to be important. It's always going to be something that we're going to strive for. So let's get into the facts, the numbers. And like I like to say, there's two things that don't lie in this world: Shakira's hips and numbers. Numbers are going to tell the tale of the tape. They're really going to be what supports our actions, right? So as we look at this, according to a 2017 National Association of Realtors study that was conducted on the importance of staging, on screen are just a few of the insights that we've got from them. So let's look at those. Over 75% of buyers indicated staging makes it easier to visualize a property as a future home, whereas 49% of buyer's agents say that staging a home increases a dollar value offered. Yet 40% of buyers are more willing to walk through the home that they saw online if it is staged and staged correctly. And as well as 62% of the seller's agents say that staging a home decreases the amount of time a home spends on the market. So this is going to be a bulk of the information. By the way, you're going to get a full copy of this slide deck. So you're going to get all the information that we're running through. So you're going to have this. Don't worry about writing it down. Don't worry about taking any screenshots. But what hard-hitting facts, right? These are four hard-hitting sets of numbers that are going to let us know exactly that staging is working correct for us. Now, granted, this was 2017. This is about 3 years ago. But staging is going to be very important. So what areas are these for? That's a great question, Kate. Kate, I don't have a specific, but again, this was a National Association's Realtors poll that was taken, right? So they had taken over the bulk across the United States. This is a bulk of the information. I can see if I can lean into getting you some hyper-localized results, but this is what we got right now. Follow up with me afterwards. I'd love to follow up with you on that. Moving on, let's get into our tools and tactics. Now that we know why the topic is important, I want to share some best practices and tools with you that will allow you to choose when and where to start to utilize this for your business, right? And Lisa's coming in with, we'll be interested to know the value of virtual versus real staging. If we have time at the end of this, I would love to open up that topic for conversation, to open up the line of channel. So let's go ahead and put a pin in that. Again, you will receive the PowerPoint presentation after this webinar, along with a lovely email from me is included. So let's move forward. So staging is about moving items either out, around, or in. And as we start to look at this, it's really going to fall into these three buckets. Out means less is often more. The first step is usually to declutter and to clear out. Now, we definitely want to make sure that we are utilizing some bedside manner and being very sensitive that, hey, you know what? Your 52 Velvet Elvis paintings, they might not be something that we want to keep in the house. We know you're very passionate about them. You love them. They are art, but maybe that's not going to appeal to the broad masses, right? So typically we want to move some things out, right? Now we're going to talk about moving things around, rearranging furniture and its belongings to improve the flow, the feng shui, if you will, right? To draw buyers in and to fill in those empty spaces. And then we want to talk moving things in. Thoughtfully add new pieces to make space for more inviting environment and bringing a lot of life to that specific room or area. Getting into our next section, we are going to actually do a live assessment. See what we'd say, see what jumps out at us, what they've done, and then we're going to compare the notes, right? So we're going to ask for volunteers to raise their hand and come on board. So we'll be doing that next. Let's go ahead and move forward and see what this looks like. So we've got a picture of a kitchen. Look at this beautiful kitchen. It's arranged properly. So what I would love to do is invite somebody to jump on and tell me what they see, what jumps out at them, what's done correctly, what's not done correctly. Let's talk about that. Let's see those hands get raised. First person to shoot their hand up. Let's see if we can get you to come on deck. Here we go, Rosen. All right. And let's see if we've got you. Rosalie, how are you? Are you there? You may have to unmute yourself.
Okay. All right.
Can you hear me? Rosalie. How are you doing? First time caller, long time listener.
Thank you. Well, I'm excited to be on this with you and everyone else.
Absolutely. We're excited to have you. So yeah. Tell me, Rosalie, what do you see? What jumps out at you in terms of the staging of this specific photo?
Well, let me just give you a little background. So I, before I became a real estate agent, was a home stager for 16 mm-hmm. years. I actually started before staging, before people knew what staging was. So I'm excited to share what I actually see in this photo. I think it's a beautiful kitchen. However, if I were shooting this for, for a brochure or something, I certainly, I like the idea of the flowers, but I think they're too high on the table. I think mm-hmm. that there needs to be a clear vision of the backyard, especially if it's a nice backyard.
Okay.
I have a problem with the garbage can.
We're seeing that. That's a popular item coming across the chat. So a good couple of tips on what you would do slightly different to make it better. What do you see is right with this?
What I see is right is I think that the kitchen has, good lighting. I think that, I don't know if, you want me to comment on the clarity of the picture, but I think it's, typically I would take a lot of the stuff off the counter and I think there's still too much on the counter.
Okay.
But as far as what's right, the colors are good. The
cabinetry
looks good. There's a rug on the floor there that I would probably remove.
Absolutely. Let's see what the notes, I love, by the way, that we got you on there. What a treat to have you on there that has that experience. Let's see what we said and pointed out as far as items that we thought were right and wrong. So bringing in items that add charm. So whereas the flowers may have been too tall, I think we could both agree that maybe adding something to add some additional splash of color, just a splash, nothing too overwhelming, right? Also having clear workspaces, I think is going to be a great, it's going to be a great option for people to be able to envision what they would do with that. And then obviously clean, clean, clean. But I do agree with what you're saying and what a lot of people are saying. Maybe we remove that trash can. Maybe that's not a great place, but make it simpler, right? Use accents that really only increase the value of the scene that we're painting rather than take away from it. Thank you so much for coming aboard. And you're going to have other options to come on as well, too. Let's go ahead and move on. I'm going to go ahead and mute you, but thanks again. Let's move on to the next picture, and we'll see what we see. Here we go. And let's see who else can we get to start to comment on what we see in this picture. So let's see if we've got a few different hands raised. See if we got you all coming in. Pura, I'm going to go ahead and unmute you. Pura, how are you doing? You may have to unmute yourself.
I'm okay. How are you?
Good. Good to hear from you, Pura. So let's talk about now this room, right? We moved on from the kitchen. Let's talk about this from a staging point of view. What jumps out at you? What do you see? What do you feel when you're looking at this room? Let's take just a minute or two to look at that.
Well, it already feels crowded because we have that chair mm-hmm. sort of right in the center front of the picture.
Okay.
And then column on the lower right. The angle kind of, it's straight on, and I think that it would look better if it was sort of at a 45 degree angle, maybe have a wider view with less of the ceiling and more of the floor.
Okay.
Also perhaps if it were brighter, it would also open up the space a little bit more in the picture.
And I think all those are great tips in terms of our photos. for, say, showcasing a home, what would you think in terms of maybe people actually being at this property? If they were here, they were actually visiting it, what do you think the feel, what do you think went right with this layout?
Well, I think it's very inviting. I think that people would feel comfortable sitting and kind of just being in the space. It's very homey and warm.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So if that's what appeals to the client, then that's a major plus.
Absolutely. Let's see what we said. I want to keep it on the line for a second. We got a lot of great comments coming through. Window treatments, frame view, beachy vibe, stages, a yoga studio, right? Or I would open the door. So a lot of good, a lot of bad. Let's see what the survey said. I don't have a ding for this. I wish I had a game show ding. But give every room its defined purpose, right? So when we're talking about this, you kind of talked about it. It's kind of inviting. It's kind of a conversation room. Potentially want to move a little bit more furniture in, maybe get rid of some of those chairs, but we do want to have something in this space, right? We also want to talk about looking at the refinished floors. It's a good way to draw in attention. And then they noted, and you can't really see it here, and I'm going to flash back, I'm going to flash forward. You want to highlight any additional smart features that a home might have. Right. So that's what that went right with the house. But I love the fact that we're already starting to look at what would we potentially feature, what we do different when it comes to these properties. Pira, thank you so much for coming on live with us. And then again, you're going to get some more opportunities to do that a little bit later on down the line.
Okay. Well, thank you so much.
Mm-hmm. All right. Moving on next. Let's see what we've got. So this is a great room. Let's get those hands shooting up. I love to see who we've got to comment on this. What do we see? What jumps out at us? Let's see what we got going on. Okay, Christina, let me go ahead and unmute you. You may have to unmute yourself.
Hello, can you hear me?
I can hear you loud and clear. Christina, how you doing?
I'm good, how are you?
Great, thank you for coming on board. So we're looking at this open family room, right? We see a kitchen back there. What jumps out at you that's maybe a few things that are opportunities and a few things that you think are right?
The one thing that definitely stands out the most to me is that the sectional is too large for the space, mm-hmm. or that it looks too large because of the proportions to the carpet. So either getting a larger carpet or a smaller sectional.
Okay.
And then the second thing would be, despite the fact that it has those beautiful floors and the cabinetry does go with the floors, I think it sections the room a little too much by having the dark cabinetry. So I would have gone with white cabinetry.
Okay, maybe a couple different features that you would change. Now, what do you think went right with this property?
The windows are fantastic, but I know that had nothing to do with the stager. I think the floors are showcased well because they're uninterrupted. So you see the length of the floor from the beginning mm-hmm. of the room to the end.
Right.
I think they did a relatively good job of not blocking the light. I'm glad they didn't put drapes or anything up because that would have made the ceilings look lower.
Absolutely. And we're getting a couple comments coming through. Christina, let me keep you on board. Let's see what survey says on this. So we're looking at this and want to make sure we move the furniture off the walls to create conversational areas where the furniture might have been a little bit too big. They did do a good job of opening it up just a bit. We want to make sure that we do keep some pictures, but this now here's where I would disagree and you may lean in with me or not. I wouldn't put too many family photos up. Or leave too many up when you're getting a home ready to showcase to people. One, for privacy issues, but two, you want to make sure that they can picture themselves in that home. So you don't want to make sure that, you want to make sure that they're not feeling like they're visiting anybody. What do you think, Christina?
Yeah, I would agree. I think if you see too much of the family that's living there, it's hard for you to picture yourself.
Absolutely. And then last but not least, and I can let you know that this is absolutely correct. You want to make sure you put away the toys. We don't want to create a Home Alone 4, right? So where they're tripping over toys, they're stepping over them. I've got two under two. So I could tell you it gets a little bit cluttered there, if you will. We got to declutter some of those toys. But overall, you know, they opened up the flow of the room. They tried to add some ambiance to it, but there could be some opportunities. Christina, thank you so much for coming on board.
Thanks.
Mm-hmm. Great contribution. You guys are knocking it out of the park today. Let's open it up to this one. Now, I love to see what comments we've got jumping in on this room. And again, great comments coming through on the chat as well too. So keep them coming, right? What would we say about this? Who wants to go ahead and take this room on? Remember, we just need to raise our hand and we can unmute our mics when y'all come on board. And if you've already come on board, but you have some opinions on this, I'd love to hear from that as well too. Let's see. And don't see any hands raised just yet. Let's see. Who do we have? Oh, yeah, Lisa. Let me go and see if we got Lisa. Lisa, how are you?
I'm great. I'm up in New Hampshire. How are you?
Hey, New Hampshire. Well, California says hello to you, and I'd love to hear what you say about this photo. What do you think? What jumps out at you as potential opportunities? What jumps out at you as things that are right?
The things that are right are this architectural detailing, and I do love how the carpet goes up the stairs and it matches the carpet at the bottom. Mm-hmm. So I don't know, it kind of adds for more drama, but then it goes up to the Madonna, and I think that having too many spiritual items or you know, just too many personal type things like that. That's my dog.
Yeah, they agree.
So yeah, she agrees. The other thing is I see like a little bit of side tables on the side of this, but it would really be nice to put maybe some greenery, some big tall green plants on either side of that entry.
Yeah.
Because it's a little bit barren looking at that floor.
Yeah. I love that opportunity. You really picked up on a lot of key things. And a lot of people are in agreement with you as well, too. Teresa said that, you know, maybe get rid of the statue. The art is a little bit too heavy. The light is dull. Let's see what survey said. Went right on this, right? So we want to make sure that we draw attention in. Maybe we get rid of the statue, but we do put a piece up there that draws in that line of sight, right?
Yep.
Do add some of that color. And you're one of the first people to say, hey, let's add some greenery in there. I love that, right? Get the fake plants out of there. Let's get them out of there, right? But maybe let's get some real ones in for the showing. You know, great angle, great spacious. Imagine walking into this. And again, we want you to put the hat on of somebody walking in, actually being at the property, not just staging it for photos. I mean, that's a great opportunity, but we're also staging for the clients to be there, right? So one, we want to invite them in from the pictures, but two, we want them to be wowed when they're there. A lot of great commentary. Thank you so much, Lisa. And what was the dog's name?
That was Ginger Snap.
Oh, Ginger Snap. Thanks for coming on board too. We loved your comments. We're going to go ahead and mute you guys, and then you'll have another opportunity to jump back on board a little later. Thanks, Lisa. Thanks, Ginger Snap. All right. So much great content. Let's get into this one. Now, this is one of my favorite slides that we go through. I love to see what you got on this. So somebody go ahead and shoot your hand up. Let's see what we think of this room, what your take is. And let's see who we have. Going to move down the line. And I've got Ellen. Ellen, how you doing today?
Hi, Jeff. I'm doing well. How are you?
Good. Good to hear from you. So let's take on this master bedroom, or let's just say bedroom for argument's sake. We can get into that in just a second. But what do you think went right? What do you think went wrong? Let's talk about that.
I have a really quick question, though, because I am brand new to this.
Sure.
Are staging and remodeling kind of, they go hand in hand with each other, or?
You know, that, you know, they're definitely going to be almost within the same vicinity, but definitely different, right? Staging is going to be setting up the idea or the look, right?
Okay.
We're going to paint the framework or like the template or the idea, whereas remodeling is going to be definitely a permanent fixture. Staging is going to be, this is what you could do. This is how this room could exist, whereas remodeling is going to be permanent corrections or additions. So that would be two different ways to look at it, but brand new or not, let's hear what you got. Knock us out.
So I would say definitely change something with the curtains, maybe add a little bit more color to them.
Okay.
That would be mine, and possibly even the bed. I would probably change that out as well, the comforter.
Okay.
Yeah.
And what do you think went right with it?
I like the lighting of it, the wall, how light the walls are, and the lamp kind of over to the side on the
love
left.
It. And then, oh, what was that? I couldn't hear you, Ellen. What'd you say?
Oh, I'm sorry. I like the chair and the little side table right next to it.
Okay. So we've got some opportunities in here, but we got some wins as well too. And I see Eric and a lot of bodies are coming in saying, hey, that's lighting. Open those windows up. Well, I definitely agree, unless there's train tracks right behind there. Then you don't want to open them up. But I'm assuming there's not. There's a lot of great light coming in. Let's see what survey said. So we're talking about creating a clean and gender neutral master bedroom or any given room, right? As well as making sure we declutter. We don't put too much in there. Maybe that rug does come out. Maybe that's adding to the declutter. I did see maybe we got some wrinkles on the bed. Maybe pull the chair away from the center corner, right? So there's some opportunities. But we do want to create a master bedroom that could appeal to everybody. Really want to create any bedroom that could appeal to everybody unless it's super designated, right? If it is designated, if it is something that has a specific intent, we want to make sure that we almost give it that intent, right? So again, keep it neutral, but guest bedrooms should look like guest bedrooms. Kids' rooms could look like kids' rooms. You know, there's a if on that, right? Maybe, maybe not. Maybe we don't want to lock somebody in a room that maybe doesn't have kids, right? I would put a color pillow on the chair. I love that little splash. Empty closets to 1/3 full. I love that tip as well too. Lisa, thank you so much for that. Terry, thank you for the tip. Love it. Again, so the idea of just taking pictures, but also what are people going to see when they're actually there? And maybe would have put a white rug, maybe a little shag carpet in there, right? A little Austin Powers action. Let's go ahead and move on to the next photo. Thanks for the participation, Ellen. And let's move into this. Who would like to take this last stab? I would love to see who wants to jump up. Hands raised. Make sure you unmute yourself. And your pets can be on if they want. This is a nice backyard. Who would love to discuss this? Let's see who we got. Okay. And we got Debbie. Debbie, how you doing today? Debbie, you may be on mute. You just might have to unmute yourself.
Hi. Can you hear me now? There
you
go,
Debbie. I can hear you now loud and clear.
Yeah, hi. So I think right across the pool, the chairs are uneven, so you'd want to even those out. And I don't like the shot taken from the back of those chairs. There's got to be a better view of this beautiful pool rather than looking at the back of the chairs.
Sure.
I would add some pretty things on those, on each of the chairs across the pool to try to attract some attention to it. But I would accent the vista and the pool rather than the back of the chairs.
Yeah, absolutely. And so for photo sake, maybe there's some opportunity there, but there's some great winds and some great material to work from. Maybe we even throw in like a really cool swan, blow up swan in there, depending on the demographic that we're looking at, right? So let's go ahead and look at what survey says on this. So we're looking at let staging outdoors create the lifestyle that people want. Absolutely, lifestyle they want. Also suggest adding items such as maybe a swing or a drink set, something that's not too overwhelming, but I think adding these little accents as well too. We wanna make sure the pool obviously is clean, leaf-free. We wanna make sure that we take care of that as well too. But we really wanna use those opportunities, and Debbie, I think you bring a great point. Utilize that vista. Let's see, Lisa said, I would have had drinks or fruit instead of their fruit, absolutely. Or color pillows on the chairs. Lee, I think that's a great option right across the pool if we're gonna utilize those chairs. Debbie, thank you so much for your input. Thank you for jumping on board. I appreciate that. I'm going to go ahead and throw you back on mute, but you'll have an opportunity later on to join in. And thank you, everybody, for chatting through. So what I love about this and this exercise is, again, you're going to get a copy of the slides. Everybody's already active in what they would potentially do, not for themselves, but from somebody coming in. How can we create a neutral battlefield, right? A neutral ground to where people can see it and it's appealing, but it's not too mundane, not too vanilla. We want to make sure that we're utilizing the strengths. So I love that you're already starting to see what you would do in a staging purpose for photos and for actually people being there. So good job, everyone. Now let's get into our next game. That's right. It's going to be our next game. We're looking at bang for your buck. Bang for your buck. We're going to look at where you're going to spend your money because Jeff just gave you a magic unlimited money card. So when we look in bang in your buck, let's do this. Bang for your buck, where would you invest your money, right? So we definitely have surveys and polls on this, but I'm gonna go ahead and open up the poll for this. We've got some choices up there. We've got living room, master bedroom. Don't come in on chat. We're gonna open up the poll in a second. Living room, master bedroom, guest bedroom, kitchen, all rooms, or maybe we have some other rooms. Let's go ahead and get into this real quick. Open up this one. And let's launch that poll. Let's put a minute and a half on the clock, and I'd love to see what 122 of you say about this. Where would you do it? Jeff just gave you, Bank of the Jeff, unlimited money, unlimited funds. Where would you invest that in terms of your staging dollars, whether it was in person or whether it was for photos or both? Let's talk about that. And those votes are rolling in. We have more than half of you coming in. With just 30 more seconds on the clock, we're not going to need to give you too much time because they are flying in. Okay. 100 of you have voted. There's still 22 on deck, so we still got 83%, but that is starting to climb. Let's see what we got. 8 seconds left. That elusive 100%. Well, I don't think we'll ever get that on a poll, but we're getting a great amount of contribution. Let's go ahead and end this poll. Thank you, Alex Trebek, for lending me that track. And let's share these results. As we're looking at this, 19% of you said you would invest your money in the living room, whereas 5% of you said master bedroom. 1% of you said guest bedroom. An overwhelming 42% of you said the kitchen. 32% said, hey, I'm going to spread the wealth. Everybody's going to get a little love. And then 1% of you said other. I would love to hear from somebody who voted for our overwhelming topic winner, kitchen. Who would like to raise their hand? I would love to bring you on real quick so we can just discuss this. And I won't say whether I agree or disagree, but I would love to hear, why did you vote for kitchen? Let's see who has their hand. Okay, Kate, I'm going to go ahead and unmute you, Kate. Kate, how you doing?
I'm great. Thank you. How are you?
Kate is great. Jeff is doing well, too. So, Kate, why did you vote for the kitchen? Talk to me about that.
So when you take buyers through or yourself as a homeowner, the center of the home is in the kitchen. Mm-hmm. That's where we spend most of our time. And that's where most memories are made collectively with family and friends.
Oh, yeah. You know what? I mean, I couldn't argue with that. You're spot on the money. We spend a majority of our time in the kitchen. We're eating, we're talking, we're gathering. I mean, I can remember back to family holidays where we gather in the kitchen as the food's being made. It can't even come out quick enough because we're eating it, right? Maybe we have a little bit of wine. The cousins are talking. Everybody's visiting. So absolutely. I'm going to write down the contact in the kitchen with my buyers. Absolutely, right? So it's a great opportunity. None of these are necessarily wrong. But there's a few that are going to give us a better opportunity. Kate, thank you so much. You were great. Thank you for coming on board. You're going to have some more opportunities. I'm going to go ahead and mute you, but thanks so much. Okay, let's see. Here we go. All right. So a lot of great participation. Let's see what survey said, though. When we look at this, survey says two different views when it comes to the house from a buyer's perspective and from a seller's perspective. Again, this information was sourced from a National Association of Realtors 2017 study. The most commonly staged rooms are the living room, kitchen, and the master bedroom. The importance of each of these they surprisingly vary between the buyers and sellers. But you're going to have an opportunity to look at this, right? Tammy said she went with all rooms because I have unlimited funds. Tammy, you do. You definitely do. And then master bedroom is definitely important. Again, from your different perspective, there's going to be a different gauge of importance. Now, no one's wrong, but it just happens to be what we think is going to need that. Now, you may roll into a place where the kitchen is already locked up. It's great. It's fabulous. You don't need to do much. So maybe some of those other bedrooms need a little bit of love. The point of this is start to think what you would do with how much you have to spend, right? All right. So building a case, common client objections. This is a fun part. And we are making some great time. So, you know, these are going to be four common objections. What I want to do now is we're going to get one volunteer per objection. We're going to do objection handling online, and then we're going to look at what the script would potentially say. Now, this is just going to compare to see where we're at with this process. I'd love to get your thoughts, your opinions, but let's lean into the first one, and let's go with this objection. Who would like to take this old, seller, this hard, pesky seller on. Let's see those hands raised. Who would like to come on and handle my objection? And I haven't seen a hand raised yet. Remember, you can raise your hand and bring you on. And let's see, who do we got? We've got one, I want to say closer to the top. Here we go. Kate, we're going to bring you back on board. You're the first one that I saw. Kate, here you go. Kate, I think you're back on with us. Yes?
Okay.
All right. So, Kate, I'm going to be your pesky seller, right? And you know what? I'm not too sure
Yeah.
I'm not too sure that staging is worth it. Why do we got a stage? It's not worth it to me.
Well, you know what it is. Unfortunately, many people can't visualize what furniture is going to fit in the space. You know, it's just not an innate thing for everybody. So by putting in, you know, a sofa, a coffee table, and a couple of sitting chairs, it allows the buyer to come through and visualize their own furniture in the space, and that helps us sell the house.
Well, you know what? You won me over. This objection is done. I say yes, let's go with staging. Thank you so much, Kate. Let me go ahead and put you on mute, but let's see what we said script-wise. So script-wise said, Mr. or Mrs. Seller, did you know that when staging a house, 29% of sellers' agents reported an increase of between 1% and 5% of the dollar value by buyers compared to similar properties? 21% of respondents stated that staging a home increased the dollar value of the property between 6 and 10%, right? So there are some hard facts. I love that, you know, she started to say visualize. We want to start to visualize, but we want to also increase that potential dollar amount. We want to give them that spark of creativity. I love what Eric said. Eric said, you know what? You call me, Jeff, when you're really serious and you're ready to sell. Eric's not messing around. I like that. Let's get into our next objection. Who would like to take on this grumpy old guy when it comes to the next objection? I'm not going to let you know what it is, but who wants to take on the next objection? Let's surprise ourselves. No hands raised. Let's move on. Maybe you'll be enticed by the objection. You know what? But this is my style. Let's talk about this. Who would like to take on this objection? Okay. And we have Douglas. Douglas, are you there? You may have to unmute yourself, Douglas.
Yeah. Can you hear me?
Oh, I can hear you loud and clear. Welcome on, Douglas. So you know what? Douglas, this is my style. I happen to do love those 42 Velvet Elvis paintings. Why can't we just leave them up? This is beautiful staging as it is.
And you're absolutely right. There's nothing wrong with this, and it appeals to you. But what we're trying to do is get appeal to the broader public, and we want to get you the most money for your house. So why not, you know, go with something more neutral?
Douglas, you've definitely done this before because that was absolutely spot on. Let's go ahead and see what service said. Douglas, thanks for jumping on. I'm going to go ahead and put you back on mute, but let's see what our scripts say. One second. Here we go. You know what? I respect and appreciate that. However, it may not be the style of the buyers. Our job is to present your property in an attractive blank canvas where the buyers can see themselves creating their own style with their personal belongings. And don't you want to bring your personal style into your new home anyways, right? So I love that Douglas was spot on with that. That's such a great way. Again, bedside manner, we want to deliver the blow with as much finesse as we possibly can. Let's go ahead and move on. Who would love to take this one on? Why do I have to remove my personal items? Why? Lisa, let's go ahead and grab you. That hand shot right up. So Lisa, there you go, Lisa. Welcome back.
Hi.
Lisa, why would I have to remove my personal items? Why?
Well, listen, I know that you really appreciate having those, the artwork of all the nude men that you have above your master bedroom, and you have a nude statue in the bathroom. So I'm just thinking we're gonna have to bring children through the house. So we probably want to pack your stuff, get it packed now, so you're way ahead of the game. And then when people come into the property, they're not looking at your stuff. They're looking at the home that they wanna move their stuff into. Does that sound okay to you?
You know, that you make a great point. You make a great point. Might as well get the stuff moved in, moved out, and already moved on. I'm not going to ask the backstory behind that first imagery that you were talking about there, yeah, but
it was a true story.
I have a feeling. I had a feeling. Lisa, thank you for coming on board. Let's go ahead and see what we said as far as the survey. Let's go with your personal belongings may distract your buyer's attention from the house itself. We want them to focus on picturing their own personal belongings in the house. And look at it this way. Eventually, you're going to have to pack up everything anyways. We're getting a head start on moving your house by doing some of the work now, right? New Hampshire, laugh out loud, Lisa. Absolutely true story. You know, follow her up. that story. We're not going to post that on here. But you know what? She was spot on, right? Let's picture the them in there. And I'm going to ask everybody an important question out of all these scripts that we see and some of the content that we're talking about. But she said, hey, you know what? Let's give them a blank slate and let's get an early start on that packing, right? We've got one more to go. Let's see who wants to take on this. You know what? I don't have time to fix anything. I just come as you are. It is what it is. Who would love to take this objection on? First hands raised. Let's see who we have. Oh, yep. Welcome aboard. How are you doing? Let's see. We got Douglas and Pura as well, too. Let's go ahead. Let's bring Pura on. Pura, you may have to unmute yourself.
Well, I would say that any time that you don't have to fix it is time that you'll probably spend showing it. So it's better to just fix it in the beginning so that you can find a buyer sooner.
Okay, right. So take care of it now so it won't impact me later. Pura, you're absolutely right. No wonder I hired you for this. I think I should start to fix that right now. Thank you for jumping on board for that last one, Pura. Let me go ahead and throw you back on to mute. Let's see, where are you at? There you are. Let's go ahead and lower those hands. But let's see what survey says on that, right? You must price this home accordingly. Absolutely. This is when I introduce the home warranty. Lisa hits them hard with a home warranty. Let's see what we got. Great comments coming through. Everybody's chiming in. Let's see what survey said. Time is money here. If people think that your house is not being well maintained, well, they're going to come to come in with a lower offer or lower bid and it may bring in not what we want for our home, right? Statistics show that sellers can get anywhere from 1 to 10% in more dollar value of a property when it has been staged and when it has been fixed. Now, we do have some programs across the company, across the nation, that could help us with these efforts, right? So you want to lean into your branch managers, find out a little bit more about that content, about more about those programs. But we do have the ability to offer you some aid through that, through Coldwell Banker as well, too. Thank you so much for everybody, right? Lisa's saying, when I introduce a home warranty, Revitalize is coming through. I didn't want to say it. You said it, but I agree with it. Revitalize is a great program. There may be other programs that are named differently in your areas, right? All right. So staging costs, what's your experience? So what's your experience been when it comes to staging? What is the immediate amount of staging and who pays for it? We're going to look at all of that right now. Getting into this, 62% of the sellers offer the service, as something that's included, whereas 39% of sellers pay for it before the listing, 10% of sellers after the home is sold, and then 3% agents firm pays for staging. This is across the board of 100 different scenarios for 2017, right? And the average pricing for staging is about $675. Now, that may vary from area to area. I know here in California, we are our own little hub, our own little bubble, especially in the Bay Area. So that might be inflated upwards towards the north. But you're going to look at a median cost across the board of $675. And I've looked at a few of those. Kathleen's saying that number is very, very low. And again, to your area, you may want to look into what that average cost is. So it may be a little bit more north, it might be south, or it might be even. And then this is just one of the percentages that I'm actually going to share, right? You'll get the slides from his virtual meeting. You absolutely will, Lily. And oh my God, that's low. 2,000 is more on the average. Again, this is going to be just one sampling of that. And keep in mind, this is 2017. I'm not too sure how much that increased or what type of staging. But again, it's going to vary on the property, what you need, and what's going to be going, right? So consider that. Now let's get into staging and photography. So by the numbers, over 90% of buyers look online at properties as their first step in the process, right? So now we're going to talk about the importance of those photos. We were kind of bringing it on board earlier, but we're going to talk about that now. Also, 89% of buyers found photos of properties very useful. Right. So let's see. Donald comes in. Is a staging cost for renting the furniture for X months or just professional advice from a stager? Donald, that is a great question. It doesn't really dice down to that granular of information, but I would assume it, you know, it could run the gamut. So again, you're going to want to look specifically in your area of how that charge will be applied. But getting back into photos, by the numbers, this is how it could benefit you. Now let's start to look into the use of photography to entice buyers to visit, right? We want to create an idea of, I must see this place, right? We want to see this place. Think of it almost like dating, right? You want to put those best pictures forward because you want them to come to see that property or that person, right? Any stats more relevant than 2017? Jessica, unfortunately, I don't have anything supplied here, but I could see what I could drum up in my follow-up email or try to follow up with me and we can see if we can dig up some information. So professional photography, the pros to this are going to be high quality professional guidance on a shot, angles, composition, and lighting, and it frees you up to do work on other areas of business, right? The DIY photography, it's going to be fast photos, can be taken the same day. You could take them from your iPhone, right? So if you have your phone handy, you could definitely take them. Also, it lowers the cost out of pocket. So your phones might have a high res rendering of those photos, right? But these are going to be the pros. Let's go into the cons. With the pros, we have the cons. So the cons of professional photography, I'm sorry, is scheduling and logistics between the seller photographer and you, right? Delay between the shots and the photo availability due to any type of editing. The out-of-pocket cost, and then the complexity arising from photo copyright loss potentially, right? And then if you're going to do it yourself, results may look lackluster next to professional shots. There's a higher opportunity for cost. Also, time spending taking the photos, editing them, is time that you could be building your pipeline of business, et cetera, right? We do have a program that takes care of that in a majority of our company. It's available to us. If it's not, you want to look into that. But we do have some programs that include it within package pricing for homes that are going to make it a lot more enticing. Again, you're going to want to follow up with your branch managers to see what information is that. But a little surprised that CB would suggest personal photography as an option for listing photos as opposed to professional photography, especially given the recent introduction of listing concierge. Susan, absolutely. And again, we just want to make sure that we uncover everything across the board. We don't necessarily want to leave anything undone. These are going to be your options. We're just going to show you the pros and cons to both of those. When it comes to it, though, I would lean into whatever your gut is telling you that this property needs. Great comment, though. Thank you so much for sharing that, Susan. Let's go ahead and jump on board. So consider these tips. When we're doing professional photography, highlight or feature the seller's favorite items, provide a lockbox code for the photographer as an easy way of access, and always ensure your contact with the photographer includes the language that grants you the rights to utilize these photos when the use of a drone or twilight. Yeah, you know what? Let's see. I'm not following that, Donald. I'd love to follow up with that comment as well, too. Or when would we use a drone or twilight? Again, that's going to be applicable to you. So I love that you brought that up. Drone footage is going to give you a lay of the land. It's going to tell you a glimpse of the story that normal photography wouldn't be able to tell you, right? It's going to also give you some of the amenities. It's just going to give you that angle that you wouldn't see, right? It's very picturesque. And then twilight, I happen to love that golden hour photo. Typically, they're going to use a lot of that, but it's going to be up to your discretion on what they need, right? Let's see, DIY, consider these tips. Using a digital SLR camera, don't listen to Jeff and use your iPhone. Use your digital SLR camera with a video angle lens or a tripod. And you want to use that tripod, or you want to make sure that you are using a stabilizer, right? So stabilizer is going to look like this. Give you a second. I had this for another class I was doing today, but stabilizer, very inexpensive. If you're doing it yourself, you want to use a tripod or a stabilizer. Adjust the lighting to give the space warmth, welcoming glow. Again, that golden hour. Shoot from the corner to make the room look big, and then also enroll in an online photography class if you can. SLR, what does that stand for? That stands for, I will get back to you on that, Lori. I forgot. If anybody wants to chat on there, I will give them points for today. SLR, I completely forgot what that stands for, though. Single lens reflex. There you go. Single lens reflex. Lisa came in with the points, but Jill, you're getting them because you were right behind her. So a look forward to this. Let's start to look forward and see what we could do with this, right? So these are a couple of things that we want for you to do and to make happen. Here's a key with any of these lessons that you take. First of all, thank you so much for giving us any of your time. super, super, super grateful. It is a privilege for us to be able to do this for you. So thank you so much. What you can do with this, though, is because you spent an hour, you're never going to get back. Use one, two, or three of these tips or more to better your business and start right away. Now is the time, right? So let's talk about building your network. You want to start to reach out to your local photographers, start to build those relationships so we have those vendors handy. Also too, you want to start to do your research. Spend 30 minutes reviewing photos of recently sold homes that used staging versus homes that didn't. Start to see what that contrast was, right? They're comparable homes. Let's start to see what's happened. It's almost unacceptable to do DIY photos in our area. And it may be, absolutely. Thank you, Louisa, for that comment. The last one I have on here on making it happen, again, you're going to get this full slide deck, is you want to make sure, make your case. As it goes, a picture is worth 1,000 words. That's what it says down there, and I absolutely believe it. But we want to make sure that we're taking before and after photos, even if you are using a professional photographer, right? If you're not doing it yourself, use a professional photographer. Agree on some specific areas or spots where you're going to take pictures. Put a piece of tape down on the ground. Maybe it's a piece of transparent tape. Use a specific marker. Take a before from those exact angles. And then when the stager comes in, the staging's done with it, take an after, right? Your home's going to be set up for staging, for photography. It's going to be great for the visit. But what a 1-2 punch to say, hey, this is what I did for this property before and after with staging. Look how much we were able to yield them. Look how much we were able to get over asking. How are we able to match that, right? When it's applicable, this would state the case, right? Again, struggle for your costs. What are your thoughts? And he'll say you can spend $100 per month, $1,000, I mean, for rent. Right, or great idea. Thank you, Donald, for that. What are my suggestions on cost? Consider this. With staging, it's going to increase potentially what we're going to make for the sell of the home. So that's where really the cost is going to be potentially a wash. Potentially, right? We want to look and be smart about what we're doing. That's why we want to build those relationships. We want to do the research, right? But when we've made that decision, again, I lean into that, and that's why I have it in red. You can never unstage a home. So take the before when you've agreed on staging and then get those same angles afterwards and use that for your future business. That is absolutely an amazing opportunity. One thing that I was going to tell you I was going to talk about that I didn't mention just yet, but when in dialogues and we're talking about these properties, make sure we're always talking about the house, not your house. We want to talk about the house because we want to start to sever that emotional tie. And that way these decisions are less impactful. If you come at somebody saying, we got to declutter your house, we got to take this art down from your house, we got to do this, it starts to feel emotional. It starts to feel like an attack. But when we say the property, the home, the house, we can start to say, we could, you know, inception. We want to throw that idea in there and get them to stop to think about that, right? Let's move forward here. So what I want to do is find out final thoughts on this. It's really going to come up to you. Staging is going to offer you a lot of benefits. There's going to be a lot of things that staging can do, but it's really going to be potentially up to you. For the photos of the home, to sell the home, to get the most that you potentially can, this is something that you may want to lean into, but this is your time to think about that. Right. By no later than tomorrow morning will you receive this deck. I'm assuming by tonight. I'm hoping by tonight. If I can get to all my emails, and I definitely will. But by tomorrow, you're going to receive this deck, and you'll be able to run through this and decide. What I will need you to do is please make sure that you do complete the CBR evals. This is going to make sure that we enhance our content as well as how we did as well too. Maybe Jeff never deserves a mic and a headset, so we'll get him off the air. Or maybe you want to see more of this and you want to develop this. What I want to do is leave you with this. As a last tip, we want to talk about three keys to success. So three keys to success that I recommend. This is my gift to you. You want to make sure that you practice self-forgiveness. You want to make sure that you practice to commit. And then you maximize your level. And what I mean by that is three things. No one's going to forgive you like you. So make sure you practice self-forgiveness. Make sure that you master that because that's going to be important. You have to be able to pick yourself up and get back into the game. Self-forgiveness is key. Two, commit to what you said you were going to do. No matter if it takes you longer than you planned, commit to it. Be a person of your word. That's going to go a long way. And last but not least, the third tip is going to be maximize your level now. Don't worry about the level you want to be at. If you want $1 million, it's not going to happen overnight, right? You got to worry about, do I have $1,000 first and then I'll get to $1 million. If you can focus on mastering your level where you're at now, you will find yourself automatically leveling up. So don't worry about getting to the end game. That is your goal. But master your level now and you'll automatically be at the next level, right? That is it. Thank you so much. I hope you're well. I hope you're blessed. Make sure you take care of each other. More importantly, take care of yourself. Don't forget to high five the person that you see in the mirror. Keep being awesome. Keep looking for these classes. Make sure you do those evals. Check out my email. And I'd love to see you at any of the future classes that I have. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you again for so much of your time. You've been amazing. Thank you so much. Western region, by the way. Let me open up with that. That was it. Thanks so much, guys.